Hi you guys, my name's Laura. I am going ahead and doing a YouTube channel. This is the first time I do one, a video. I've been asked multiple times by some friends and, you know, family members to go ahead and put my recipes in the YouTube channel, and I've never had the courage to do one. And for some reason today I just feel like, hey, you know, let's just go ahead and do it and let's try and let's see what happens. So today I'm going to be cooking a Mexican dish called gorditas, which in English it means chubbies or fatties, and they're really, really good, and you will love them. You won't be able to just eat one. So we're going to be doing meat, and also for the ones that don't like meat, we're going to be doing vegetable, a root, potato. And those are my favorite ones. So I'm gonna show you what I've been cooking for the past 2 hours. And in this pot right here, I've been cooking some pork. And it's been cooking for 2 hours. Okay, and now the meat should be just about done. It should be ready. And you know when your pork's ready, when it starts just coming out like that. You see that? And what I did here, I put salt, pepper, garlic, a quarter of an onion, and some oregano. This is what's been cooking in this pot. Oops. And the meat is ready because we're going to be shredding this. So it is super, super tender, and that is what we are looking for it to just pull off the fork like that. And on this little part, we're going to be doing the potatoes. Okay, so that's the water's already boiling. I didn't season it, no salt, no nothing, just plain water. So let's walk over here. I already have my potatoes ready, cut up, ready to go. So we're going to go ahead and put these in here. Just drop your potatoes in. Okay, I should put this down. Let me see if I can put you guys down. And I don't know why I feel silly doing this video. You guys just work with me. And I'm trying to find. I don't know if you can use this. Already turned off the pork, so now we're going to be taking the pork off the pot. So we're gonna pull it out so that you'll have time to cool down so you won't burn your fingers when you start shredding it. So let's just go ahead and take it out. There we go. It is perfect. It smells very good too. And you can put as, I didn't put that much meat in here because, you know, there's only three of us here. And my husband and my son and myself. So, the faucet water, that's no problem. And we're gonna go ahead and do our measurements for the masa. All right, so I'm gonna give on my second, which I keep it in here, and I keep it in here because that way it stays fresh, it's sealed, and it's not just in the bag to where you can get labels or anything like that. So that's why I like to keep it in a sealed container. I got my water running, and while my water's running, I'm gonna go ahead and measure out the masa for you. I'm gonna get my water. We're gonna get 2 cups of warm water. So we got our water here, and what we're going to be doing, you're going to get 2 cups of maseca, 2 cups of the corn flour. It's flour, and the reason that we do the 1 cup of all-purpose flour is so that, because the corn flour doesn't have gluten in it, the flour, the white flour, all-purpose, does. and it's gonna make our dough a little bit more softer, more flexible to deal with and stretch it out. So that's why we're using this flour, just for the gluten, okay? And second, we're gonna be using our baking powder, all right? So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna get like a half a teaspoon of baking powder. You know what, let's just go ahead and do, that looks like plenty of dough. So we're gonna be doing a teaspoon of flour. So here's my teaspoon, throw it in there. And then we're gonna do a half a teaspoon of salt. So let's go ahead and get the salt. Get your half teaspoon. There you go, throw it in there. See how easy that was? All right, let's do it like this. Okay, so here's 1 cup. All right, 1, 2. Make sure you get that in there. There you go. We got 2 cups of the corn flour. Okay, and then we're gonna do, we're gonna go ahead. Every time I cook, I always have to clean up after myself. It's just makes me feel like I'm cleaner. I'm gonna go ahead and get this whisk. You can use a fork too, it doesn't matter. We're gonna mix this. Alright, so you're gonna mix it, mix all your dry ingredients. This is all you're gonna need to make your gorditas. Alright, so go ahead and mix it well. So 2 cups of the corn, 1 cup of the flour, a tablespoon of the baking powder, and a half a tablespoon of salt for flavor. Alright, now some people just use the plain corn flour to make the gorditas, and that's fine. But I like to use the flour, the flour, the all-purpose flour for the gluten. Now we're gonna make a little hole right here. And we're gonna start putting like a cup of water. Or, yeah. Make sure I have a cup right there. And what I'm gonna do is, I think I'm gonna mix it with a spoon. You don't wanna put all the water in because the dough, the flour, is going to tell us if it needs more water or not. Okay, so we're going to be mixing this, just mix it, and obviously we're going to be needing more water. It's asking for more water. So let's go ahead in there. We have put 1.5 cups of water already in here. So let's just keep mixing it, okay? And if it tells us more water, we're going to give it more water. You don't want to put too much because then you won't be able to work with it. All right, so it still feels very, very dry. So, go ahead. Feel comfortable. It might take all the water. Let's just keep going. Just keep putting bits, little by little, the water. You don't want to add too much water though. Oops. I'm asking for more. Right. Keep mixing it. Okay. Starting to make it to a little ball, but what we want it. Mixing it. Mixing it. Okay. This is where I'm going to go ahead and put my hands in here and see how it feels. Okay, here we go. Okay. See that? Just keep mixing. Okay. Remember, you don't want it too wet. Otherwise, you won't be able to work with it. Okay. Mix it. It's going to feel pretty good, actually. There we go. Very nice. Actually, it turned out really good. I'm just going to take it out. And then just going to... You don't want to knead this too much. It doesn't need it. So just keep... You just fold it. See that? It's actually good. Now you'll know your dough is ready when it's soft to the touch. See how my fingers just get in there? See that? Okay. All right. Look at this. Now, open your bowl. Let's grab your little ball and see how it turned out. See that? This is what you're looking for. Look at this. Look. See? See how soft it is? That is what you're looking for. So let's just go ahead and put this back in there. Our dough is done. Remember, do not knead it too much. It's just a little bit, just to get it into this little ball here. All right, so we're going to go ahead and put it back in the bowl there. We're going to go ahead and cover it up with a damp paper towel just to keep the flour moist so it won't dry out on you. Because remember, this is corn masa and it does tend to dry out if you don't keep it under a moist paper towel. So go ahead. It's just to keep it moist. There we go. We're going to set this aside. We're going to clean our surface here. And our masa is done. And it almost used all the 2 cups. Almost, but not quite. All right, so let's go ahead and clean up our surface. Sorry, guys. So we're going to go ahead and clean our surface here because now we're going to start shredding the meat. And that is part of our filling that we're going to be doing. And let's get our pork. So, here's our pork right here that we have set aside. So now what we're going to be doing, we're going to get it and we're going to start pulling it. And see how it's nice and shredded? It's like pulled pork pretty much. Alright. And if it's too hot still, like I can feel some of the pieces still hot, we're going to go ahead and pull it out with a fork. Okay. Let's see. My fork here. I also have my tasty beverage right over here. It's orange juice, mango juice, just in case I get super thirsty because cooking in a hot kitchen, and it gets very thirsty. So we're going to go ahead and start pulling the pork, shredding it. All right. We're not going to, obviously not going to be using all of this, but I'm at enough for, I tried to cook enough for about 2 days, and it's a good way to, I guess, save money while you cook. All right, look at this. It just shreds, it's no effort at all. Quick and fast. I'm liking this. And now we're gonna taste it for salt. I'm not, like I said, I prefer the potato ones, but since I am the cook here, I have to go ahead and taste it. So, and if there's some bits of fatty tissue in there, go ahead and take it out. And we'll discard that. But so far, this pork is very clean. And it looks good, guys. Look at this. Oh my gosh. Look at this. Look. It's great. It's just shreds by itself. No effort whatsoever. Just on its own. And that is what you want, because you don't want to be out there pulling and tugging and, you know, fighting with your choice of meat. You could make these beef also, and I'm going to show you guys on another day on how to make the beef ones. And they're actually very good. You know what, guys? This pork smells really, really good. It smells delicious. And our pork is done here. So let's go ahead and taste it. You guys. This is really good. Now, you could either serve it like this in your gordita, or we can also season it. And I think I'm going to put a little bit more seasoning. I'm going to show you guys how to give it that awesome extra taste, flavor that we want, okay? So I did save the juice here. I didn't throw it away because that juice has a lot of flavor in it. Here you go. My dog's barking for some meat here. All right, so here's my pork juice. Whoops. Hurry again. All right, so we got some of the broth. We're gonna bathe this in the broth to give it that extra flavor. Yes, look at that. Put some more broth. That gives it that delicious flavor. Now let's mix it. Look at this. OMG. Now do you see it turn into a different consistency? It's more juicy, it's not as dry. And this pork is just gonna melt in your mouth. Oh my goodness. Can you see? There we go. Oh, it's ready, guys. This is ready. This is very good. All right. So the pork is done. We're waiting for the potatoes to finish cooking. I'm gonna fill one out. They're almost ready. All right. Yeah, they're very, they're getting to the point to where I might have to be pulling them out. All right, so we're gonna set this aside. All right, what's in here? Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to get me a container for those potatoes, because we're going to mash those potatoes, okay? Hold on, guys. I'm going to have to get another container here. Alright, so let's go ahead and I'm going to put this pork back on here. And we are going to get the potatoes out. And there we go. Alright. The potatoes are done. And these potatoes are for the ones that don't want meat in their gordita. So I'm giving you guys two forms of gorditas today. One with meat and one with just potatoes. My boys love the potato ones too. They're the favorite ones. All right, so let's put these in there. Great. I'm gonna throw the water out. And we're done with that. Now we got some hot potatoes here. So what we're gonna be doing, we're gonna be seasoning these. And while I'm seasoning these, I went ahead and put my little pot here. I'm gonna show you guys. I put my pot right here, I put some oil on it, and this is where we're gonna be frying up our gorditas, okay? So for the potatoes, we're gonna be using salt. We're gonna put this away. We're gonna be using salt, pepper. I'm gonna put you guys down for a minute. Follow me. Let me see where I can take you guys. Let's put this here. I'm gonna get this out. We're gonna be getting some onion, chopped onion, dried chopped onions. We're gonna be getting some garlic powder. We got the salt. Okay. Pepper. And we're gonna be using a little bit of oregano just to give it a little flavor. Alright, let's bring this back out here. Alright. So remember, we're gonna do this measuring by palm, this one. So we're gonna use this little circle part of our palm. And we're gonna be putting some garlic. Throw it in there. Remember, use the palm of your hand. A little hole that we get right here. Pepper. And actually, everything's to taste. It's up to you how you want for it to taste. We're gonna get some chopped dried onions. Palm, throw it in there. Okay, and then we're gonna do the salt. Maybe like a half a teaspoon of salt. You don't want them too salty. Salt, okay. Now, we're not gonna be putting milk in there or nothing like that. We're just gonna mash them up dry like this. Some people like to put sour cream on them, but I really don't like that sour taste. And we're gonna wait for our oil to get hot. So let's just go ahead and mash these. And this is like a bean masher, potato masher. Okay. Alright. Mash the potatoes. Like this. And it's pretty easy. Alright. So these are pretty much gonna be the fillings for our gordita that we're gonna be doing. Okay, so we're preparing the fillings, the filling that we're gonna be putting in. So here we go. Like this, like that. And remember, we already did our dough, so our dough is ready to use. And we're just finishing up the final touches, which is the potatoes. And we're ready to shred our pork. So that's done. And our potatoes are done too. All right, guys. So here we go. See that? Right now what I'm doing, I'm just mixing all the ingredients that we just put in there, all the flavors, all the aromatics. I already put it in here and that's what we're mixing it. Make sure everything gets well mixed. Alright. So our potatoes are done. And this is the consistency that we're looking for. See? See that? They're soft. And that is what we want. And they're flavorful. See? That is what we're looking for. Surface. Okay. Let's get my paper towel that I put here. And we're going to clean the surface now, guys. Alright. Here we go. So now we got our potatoes, our dough done, and our pork is done. Now we're gonna do the gorditas, and that's why we're heating up our oil to make sure that it's nice and hot. And it has to be hot, otherwise it's not gonna work. It's gonna turn out to be like a hard tortilla kind of thing. And we don't want that. We want the pocket to open so you can slice it open and stuff it. Okay, so let's go ahead and put this away. Oops. Put this away. And now we're gonna clean our surface here. Everything nice and clean. All right, so now we got our potatoes. It is going to go with peel your potatoes somewhere. I'm gonna toss this one. Potatoes. I can smell the oil already, pretty hot. So we got a potato. We're gonna put it. I'll show you guys. Look. Here's a potato. This is the consistency we want. See? There we go. We're gonna lock our potatoes and put it right here next to our pork. There's our pork. See that? Nice and shredded. So we got, this is the fillings for our gordita. All right, let's come back over here. And now we are going to do the gordita. All right, so we're gonna go ahead, our masa is ready to go. Put it aside. And we're gonna start rolling little balls, okay? Like the size of your palm. Look at this. Okay? Some people like to put oil on their hands and do the balls, but I feel like it's soft enough and it's not sticking to my hand. You know? So we're gonna do a couple little balls here. Okay? Do the balls. Okay. This feels like it's gonna be a little too hot for me. Roll them up, make your little balls. Mm-hmm. Roll them up. Okay. You just roll them. The little balls. Like that. The balls, they don't have to be perfect circles or anything. Because we're going to be pressing them anyways. And then we're going to be putting them in the hot oil. Okay. Here's another one. Okay, so one like that. And we'll put more balls. Okay. Another one. And you're gonna keep doing this until all your dough is rolled into little balls. Okay. You don't want them too big because then it'll be too thick. You don't want them too small because then, you know, it's not gonna be big enough to stuff your little pocket. Okay, so roll it up. So I made my little balls already. All right, so we're good to go. This is gonna be a little tester. All right, so here's our balls ready to be pressed. Ready to be pressed, and we're gonna go ahead and do a tester. We're gonna test this. So I'm gonna go ahead and cover my flour again, my dough. Remember, because we don't want for it to dry up. Okay? And we're gonna be using a tortilla press. Now, you can buy these at the grocery store. I've seen them on Amazon, but I feel like they're too pricey there, so you can go to the Mexican grocery store and you can find them there. This one is made out of iron, and they also make them out of wood. So it doesn't matter which way you get them, just as long as you have one. And if you don't have one, I'm gonna show you how to do it with hands, with your hand, okay? So we're gonna just slightly push this because it's a small little tester. We're not making something big here. See how? the plastic just came out of it. Look. Look at this. This is what we want. This is what we're going to test our oil with. Okay? So let's walk over here. I'm excited to do this. Oops. Let's go down to a hot oil and put this in here. There you go. Our oil is ready. See how it pops up like that? That is what we want. And when you get it, flip it. Look at that. Our oil is ready. Oh, it looks beautiful. And you're going to be cooking this, you know, when it's ready, when it's golden brown like this. Okay, flip it again. See how it's nice and brown? And then they usually start floating to the top and they look light. So let's go ahead and take this out. Okay, and we're going to put it aside. Okay, look at that. What do you guys think? Huh? Isn't it great? Wait until you taste it. Alright, so let's go ahead and put that down. And we're going to be doing our Gorditas now. Alright. I hope you guys like this video. Put our plastic down so that our dough won't get stuck. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to get some paper towels because you want your gorditas to drain all the oil and get rid of all the extra oil that we have in there. We don't need the extra calories. All right, so now we've got our plastic here. We're ready for our gordita. I think I'm going to put you guys in a different angle that we're just going to see. How's that, guys? Do the ones with the hand, okay? Put your plastic down, put your press down, slightly press it, and then we're going to take it out. Let's go ahead and take this one out because it's done. These are called gorditas. After we do them, I'll show you what they look like. All of them done at the same time. Look at this. It's beautiful. Look at this, guys. Here. That's what we want. Alright, so let's get the other one in there. This just need this to be just a little bit more. Okay, get this pressed perfect. Okay, and this is what you need the plastic. There we go, nice. And now we're going to put it in the oil. And there it is. See that, guys? Mm-hmm. Remember, when you're working with oil, be very careful. There it goes. Look at that beautiful. Isn't that pretty? Yes. And that's what we want. Look at that. Slight, fluffy, poofy. And then we are going to stuff them inside. With nothing but deliciousness. Oh yeah. Oh, they're beautiful. They're coming out nice. They really are. I don't want to burn it though. Okay. Take it out. It's hard to do this with one hand, but here we go. Okay. Let's pull it out. Good. Look at that. There we go. Now, it's empty. Now, we're not gonna use this. We're even gonna show you guys how to do it by hand. Flip it. So, now we're gonna do it by hand. I'm gonna make this cool down so we can see. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and get a little bit of oil on my hands. I got a little bit of oil in my hands. So we're going to go ahead and get your masa and we're going to press. And we're just going to pat it. Okay. Pat it. It's looking good. See that? Oh, it looks nice. See, guys, you don't need a press. Tortilla presser. You can just do it by hand. And here you go. See that? I'm going to put in the oil. We're going to do one more. Okay? My hands still have a little bit more oil on them, so I'm going to flip this one real quick because they took me like this. Oh my goodness, it looks beautiful. Alright, put that down. Put a little bit of oil on my hands. Okay. Okay, we're going to get your little ball. I'm going to press like this. Press it. Your hands, put some pressure on it. Let me get this one out because it looks like it's ready. I'm going to break the burn. Nice. Sorry guys, we can't see this part, but let's go ahead and put it down here. Finish pressing this one. See? And the oil, it helps not stick. So go ahead and just press it. Some pressure. And here you guys are. And now we put it in the oil. Here we go. And that's how you do it without a tortilla press. You don't have to have one. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and wipe my hands. Alright. Flip this one. Very good. Flipping it very nice. Flip this down. so light. And they cook really well, so.
They look great, guys. Really good.
And I'm going to take this one out. And let's put the other one. Doing that until we finish this right here. Place it. Press. I'm just going to flip it like that. Press. And then we're going to flip this one. There we go. What you guys think? It's my first video, so I'm still learning. But you can give me some tips on how to, I guess, make a better video. I really appreciate it. Alright, let's go ahead and flip this one. And remember, this is all corn. This is how you, it's the masa to make the corn tortillas. So, look at us. There. They look beautiful. This one's very good. Where's my other thing? All right. So, we're going to go ahead and take this out. Remember, we're making what? Gorditas. They're going to be so delicious. It's like a pita kind of thing, but made out of corn. Like, I've heard some people call them fluffy tacos, but that's not what we call fluffy tacos. But some people, they do. But we call them gorditas. Alright, so there we go. This one puffed up already. They look a little bit like chocopillas kind of thing. Alright, let's get the other one in. Put your plastic in. Slowly press. There we go. Turn it around. Slightly press. Pull it out. And here we go. Now we can take this one out. Look at this. Crispy, that's what you want. Alright, I'm going to take this one out. Do just this one and then we'll start stuffing them up, okay guys? Because then this video is going to be forever. Alright. I'm going to get this one out. Put it in there. And then we're going to start stuffing them up. Put that one in there. We're done with that. Let's go to the next step, which will be stuffing them. That's the fun part. All right, so here we are. Okay, we're going to get the potato ones or we're going to get the pork ones. All let's get our meat treated. So now we're going to pork and we have our potatoes. So we're going to get a knife and we're going to get one and then we are going to cut them in the middle. Okay? So you're going to get it and then you're going to make a pocket. Make your pocket. Okay, so here's our pocket. I'm gonna get this one out. Okay. You get the one, and this is what it looks like, see? Steaming hot. See that? Yes. And then, there you go. It's stuffed with the meat. See that? And then, remember I showed you all the cheese and lettuce and tomatoes? So you're going to put some cheese in. Like that. And then, we're going to put some macaroni in it. Like that. Some lettuce. I'm gonna put, sweetheart, get ready because it's gonna be test time. Tomato. Okay. Put your tomatoes. Oh, look at that. Put your cheese. Some more cheese. A dollop of sour cream. And a little bit of this salsa. Now my husband likes salsa, but this one came a little spicy, so I'm just gonna put a little bit of it. Oh my goodness, guys, this looks delicious. It really, really does. Look at this. Look at this. It's a corn pita. Look at this, beautiful. I actually want to bite it. I promise we have. Where is the? Oh, there it is. All right. There it is. Look at this. Look at this. It's beautiful. It's gorgeous. What do you think? He doesn't want to bite into it, right? But my husband is going to be the guinea pig. So he's coming up right now and he's going to take the bite. Here's a plate. There it is. Put it down. And ready, sweetheart? Say hi.
Hi. I'm the guinea pig. The grateful guinea pig.
All right, baby, let me go ahead and turn this around so we can look at you and take the bite. Here we go. You're in full living color. Let's see, love. Let me know what you think.
Oh, my goodness. Delicious.
Is it good?
Just the right amount of spice. Very flavorful.
Show it. Let's see. What do you think of the masa?
It's very good.
Mm-hmm. Crispy at the edges.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead. Look at the camera.
Mmm. Mmm.
Crunchy. Juicy.
All of the above.
Okay. So what do you give it? Thumbs up or thumbs down?
I give it a 2 thumbs up.
Holy cow. Look at that. Mmm. Let's look at the inside. Let's take a look. Nice and juicy. There's the... focus there. There's the pork. There we go. That's better lighting right there. Lettuce, tomato, the cheese. Look at that, guys. I bet you want a bite, don't you? Make them at home. Here you go, sweetheart. And you know what I like about it, too? That it doesn't completely fall apart on you when you bite into it like a taco.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome. I love you.
After the Cardinals won.
Okay, you guys. And that's how you do gorditas. So make them at home. You will love them. It's a nice treat. They're delicious, puffy, soft, crunchy at the ends. And oh my goodness. And the potato one, it's the same way. So stuff it with potatoes, stuff it with meat, put all your sides on it, and I can guarantee you, you will have happy campers at home. Thank you so much for watching me today. And I hope you liked the recipe, and make it at home. And you will see that they are to die for, and people are going to be asking me all the time to make it for them. Thank you a lot. Subscribe, give me a like, and give me a comment. And I'll see you next time, okay? Bye.